testimony time. And I want to believe that we'll have a testifier in the house. Just quickly rush forward to the altar area and testify to the goodness of God. Our pastor's coming forward. Put your hands together for Jesus. Love for Jesus. Hallelujah. You can also rush forward and join me in the altar area for your testimony. This is our next level. Beloved, I want to thank God for today. I went to Matthew's Baptist school yesterday to tell my time of that person. Look at me, eyeball to eyeball. He said, Pastor, are you feeling fine? I keep in grace. He said, I'm feeling fine. But I thought I'm not feeling fine. I want to thank God for that time. Everything about me was sound. Beloved, I'm not going back yesterday. I'm not going to I would have not that problem. Someone was moved. I'm not going to be a problem. As I'm moving towards this other side of the six, a bike pain, you want them to go. Give me that money. Give me that. I'm still out. Suddenly, two other persons were riding on the bike. They stopped calling me and trained another person. And they were facing that person very much. Look at me, good. Because I was willing to inform my wife and children. I was willing to come that this is because of what's like. Beloved, I thank God as I went to the streets and come back. Nothing on the road happened to me. But in the night as I step up, I hear a very big sound on the roof of the house. Because I said, let me go to the family doctor. A very mighty spirit from nowhere landed to the place I was sitting, just in between me and the church. The thing did not touch me, that didn't help me. So what am I here for? I'm here to appreciate God. I'm here to acknowledge God. I'm here to thank God for what the Lord has done. And you know what? They said, I'm here to pray to the market square. Really there, really there. People were complaining. I hear a man of God, somebody called the man, of God said, the rain will stop. I came to that word, the rain will stop. I was just telling what that rain, it was not too long. He said, I said, the rain there, I cannot be praying. The rain will not stop. Don't be there, and so much God that was making, making money of God. She was ashamed. Jesus, while we are still waiting for you to come up and testify to the goodness of God, let's quickly read out this documented testimony from our online worshiper. Daddy, good morning, sir. I want to return the glory to Almighty for surprising me this morning. Just yesterday, I came into the prophecy that was released on the platform, and I wish I was worried about God fixing for me by a miracle I have this morning. It's a body clapping. A miracle I have, a body clapping, a miracle I have. By the grand of Allah this morning, may the name of God be highly exalted in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, to that healer, testifying us with gladness in our heart. And with the standing ovation, let's put our hands together for Jesus as we welcome God's servant, God, that you'll be happy for Jesus. Hallelujah.
We are indebted to you for all you have done for us. Reach up and say, I'm very sorry. In the few minutes we have in his presence, I am trusting God that many of us may have said what God has for us today.
I Place your hands on her and understand that the oil of this altar and the power of our God in his face. Every satanic impartation on that sister, on that brother, when I mention you in the same house, every satanic impartation upon my life, upon your destiny, today I command everyone. You can find that you are here now. You came here sick. But I got to see the change in your life. Thank you. You came here sick. You started finding change in your life. Is that the same? You came here sick. You started finding change in your life. Is that more like that? Father, we thank you. Bless you. All the ones in the very moment, sister, so you may know. John 1:1-5, very brief. Only you have by faith in this place, will come up in God and be my father. You will see the Lord. John 1:5. In the beginning was the Word. In him was life, and the life was the light of men, and the light shined in darkness, and darkness completely darkness. So I'll be listening on what power is in the Word of God. What power is in the Word of God? Wherever God's word is not preached, people are not reached. God was in the prophet.
Is that who you are seeing such a thing that look like jobless? Don't so
victory of few days, he can become one thing. Because the world has the component of destroying human doubts. The world has the component of making those who are doubted and rather than you are denying exist to make them know that I exist. So anyway, the world is not rich. People are not rich. However, are not rich, nobody will be rich. So the world carries power. The world carries prophecy. The world carries testimony. Let's say this way. The world carries my testimony. The world carries my prophecy. The world carries my children of people, not my children. The world carries my children of people. No doctor carries his. The world carries your aim. The world carries your praise. That's the one you want to speak in. Then let your doubts. Yes, you are human and you can doubt, but you are not only the doubt of the world created. Every manufacturer knows that his product will never doubt you because he's one of the product. So everybody wants his big rich. People are rich. And when people are rich, they become rich. If you want rich, be a politician. You don't need to stop complaining because you know that. Because God has been preaching to you. That's why you have to see that strength here. They went for preaching as they were told, and the Lord was walking with them, preaching. The Lord was on them, confirming them all with signs. Follow. That is, sign following here, following here, and following here. So when the Lord is not preaching, you can't preach. What a privilege is it for you to hear the Lord being preached to you? What the privilege for you to be here to hear the word now. That whatever is not happening now, the word that is being preached now will make it happen. Can I hear from someone right now? Can I hear from someone right now? The word we preach and confirms the testimonies. And I'm trusting God by this word today that I am preaching now. That the children have really said it. Someone who has been doubting the existence of his father only. We return back to testify today. Can you hear me say amen? When the word is being preached, people are rich. And when people are rich, their testimony is released to them. I don't know what you want God to reach out to you. On before 21st of our anniversary and the birthday, God will cause you to reach you to capture. Number two, take your seat. The world carries parasites of great miracles. The world of God carries the parasite for great miracles. The seven was able to carry parasites of plasmodium, of malaria. That is how the world carries the parasite.
The word of God handles
stagnations. For
If you want me to see you, you are not prepared to be at the same level. If you want me to see you, marriage is coming. If you want me to see a man, babies are coming. The world carries. Handles our financial prosperity. Look at the head was without God and God in Genesis chapter 1. But when it's family, life came. Family came. What produced me? What produced you as a woman? What produced cars? Automobile industries? Electricity? They provide solar energy. You want to provide aeroplane? Provide cars? And the world is speaking to you now. The world is speaking to you now, today, that yearning for you to live in the realm of stagnation.
That give back to creativity.
Supernatural creation.
the world has its own place. The Bible says, maybe you try my best, choose what I believe. You told me to chapter 30 verse 19. He said, I call everyone to remember us today. That choose what I believe. Somebody made a vision for me. And it's not that so much about you, I want you to understand. You cross the Bible and say, you want me to preserve all you pray for me. I can understand. For praying for you is no matter. Because you came for God to answer, it's not for you to answer what is the need of the problem. Don't live your life by prophecy. Live your life by more. Bible says prophecy is faith. I'm listening to the word of God. And the best Corinthians that I can say, prophecy is faith. Every of that is faith, tongues is faith. But the word of God is bad. Look at it. Though I have given your prophecy and I stand on me and know it, do I have all faith so that I can remove money or have a charity and nothing in this prophecy state? Of last person. And now my by faith, for charity, for this week, for the greatest of all, is love. So create your own world. Create your own city. I've created my own world. Nobody can come to disorganize my world. Create the future you want to see. Create the future.
Thank you.
the message. That it came to God was for you. Stop. This message. You see that last service, woman will come and confirm it. He said, no. God was pursuing you. You find that God was making love with you between this person. Or an animal coming to make love with you between this person. Or a particular fish. Sorry, a particular fish to come. From this person. From where you are. Amen.
intervention in your life that is yet to receive divine intervention. By that is in and deliverance signs. And I know you're not on Facebook. I prophesy today. Receive the divine intervention of Jesus. So shall you. In the name of the Father, receive that divine intervention over your health, over your life, over your destiny, over your eyes, over your kidney, over your intestine, over your womb, over your land. Receive it now. In the name of the Father, and the soul. And we're talking about the financial miracle this evening. Come and say to them once again. Where is that sound?